Hi guys! Welcome po sa Hugot Sip 9. Ito nga po pala si Sir GV at welcome po sa ating channel. So para sa video natin for today guys, ang pag-uusapan natin is about problem solving on sequence. So we already discuss about arithmetic sequence. We already have some discussion on geometric sequence. Now guys, ay magpa-problem solving na tayo. Application on real life situation. So ang ating objective is to solve problem related to sequence, a real-life situation. And ito po ay part ng grade 10 MELC baseball ulit. First quarter, let's have our discussion. Now if we're going to talk about arithmetic versus geometric guys, ang pag-uusapan natin dito ay kung ano ba yung arithmetic at ano yung geometric. So both of them are sequence of number, but if we're talking about arithmetic sequence, we're talking about difference. Pag geometric naman, ratio ang pinag-uusapan. So ibig sabihin, kapag arithmetic, yung difference from the first term, sa second term, third term, fourth term, and so on and so forth ay parehas. Samantalang sa ratio naman po, nakabase ang geometric sequence. So, arithmetic sequence, common difference, ang process po natin ay addition. While for geometric, common ratio, then we multiply. Okay? Let's have some problem guys. Example number one. Problem solving on sequence. Tanghalan Pasigueño has 20 seats on the front row, 26 seats on the second row, 32 seats on the third row, and continues with the last row. How many seats will there be up on the 10th row? So guys, this is an auditorium. So kahit nyo, may mga upuan po yan na patas na pataas. So ang una natin gagawin guys, we're going to identify whether this is an arithmetic or geometric. So yun yung pinaka-importante bago tayo mag-solve. So writing all of those terms guys, so mara-write natin ay 20, 26, and 32. Now, kung mapapansin nyo po guys, ito ay mag-a-under ng arithmetic. Kasi nga po, 26 minus 20 is 6, 32 minus 26 is 6. So therefore, meron siyang common difference na equal to 6. Therefore, ito po ay arithmetic sequence. Hindi siya papasok guys ng geometric kasi nga po, 20 divided by 26, hindi papasok yan guys. 32 divided by 26, magkakaiba yan. Mag-iiba siya para sa ratio. And that's why naging arithmetic siya. So since arithmetic to, ang solution po natin will deal with arithmetic sequence. Solving for the 10th term, since we're looking for the 10th seat possible, an equals to a sub 1 plus quantity n minus 1 times d. Since that is the general formula for term for arithmetic sequence. So pag nasolve po natin, 20 plus 10 minus 1 times 6, which is the difference, magiging 20 plus 9 times 6, that is 54, 20 plus 54 is 74 seats. Ibig sabihin, sa 10th row ay 74 seats. Okay? So just apply what you have learned on our previous discussion, mas madali niyo po itong masosolve. Now, we will continue the next item, guys. So, eto guys, nalagay na natin. So, alam nyo, ito po ay ratio. So, a newly opened restaurant has 2 customers on the first day, 6 in the second, 18 on the third, and 54 on the fourth day. If this progress can be manifested every day, sabihin, consistent yung progress nila, how many customers will there be on the 10th day? So, napansin nyo po guys, ito naman, ang common naman nila ay ratio. Because 6 divided by 2 is 3, 18 divided by 6 is 3, 54 divided by 3 is, si 18 is 3. Ibig sabihin, there will be a common ratio. Therefore, this is a geometric sequence. After identifying that this is a geometric sequence, dyan tayo guys magsosolve. Now, if we're going to solve then guys, or after we find that the ratio is 3, ngayon po ang formula natin ay a sub n is equal to a sub 1 or raised to n minus 1. So we identify, we're looking for the 10, kaya po ito ay 10. A sub 1 is the first term, kaya po ito ay 2. 3 po ang ating ratio, that's r. ang n po natin ay 10. So after nun, solve lang natin guys, syempre yung sa denominator. 10 minus 1, it's 9. Now, 3 raised to 9 is definitely guys, 19,683. Minus 2 is 39,366. Ibig sabihin, on the 10th day, meron po silang 39,666 customer. Hindi ko alam kung paano na may accommodate ng ganyang kadami. Pero kung consistent basis guys, ganyang kadaming customer nila on the 10th day. Okay? So, ganun guys ang pag-solve nun. Identify mo lang na arithmetic, identify mo lang geometric, apply mo yung mga formulang natutunan ninyo, then may sagot ka na. Now, hindi limited guys dun sa term, looking for term ang ginagawa natin. Pwede rin pumasok guys dito yung mga sum ng arithmetic at sum ng geometric. Example po ito. Find the total number of meals ordered in a restaurant if there will be, yan, merong timetable. 3, 11, 19, 27, 35, 43, 51, 59, 67, and 75 on the first 10th day. Ibig sabihin, kung i-add natin guys, malalaman agad natin yung total number niyan. But, we're going to apply siyempre yung konsepto ng arithmetic. Therefore, we're going to look for S sub n is equal to n over 2 times first term, times the sum of the first term and the last term. So, ibig sabihin, that will become n natin ay siyempre 10. Tapos po ang ating first term is 3 and second term natin 75. So applying those item, may isang 10 over 2, 3 plus 75, that ibig 78, times 5. 5 came from 10 divided by 2, kaya po tayo may 390. Ibig sabihin po, mayroong 390 ordered meals on the 10th day, on those 10th day guys. So mali po yung parang, there will be 10 on the first day to the 10th day. Ibig sabihin, during that 10-day period, meron po silang 390 orders. Okay? And that's how we try to solve them. So, ibig sabihin, problem solving will not only be limited for looking for terms, but it also deals with the product. O sabi natin guys, not product, but we're looking for the sum ng total number nila. Kung meron tayo guys problem on arithmetic, we're also going to have some problem on geometric that we're looking for the sum. So, ibig sabihin, if the cases of virus spreading decrease from 256 on the first day, 120 on the second day, 64 on the third day, at 32 on the fourth day, and so on, how many virus could be recorded after 7 day? So, napansin nyo guys, so 120 divided by 256 is 1 half, 64 divided by 128 is 1 half, 32 divided by 64 is 1 half. Ibig sabihin guys, ang common ratio natin on those item is 1 half. So meron tayong first term na 256 tapos meron tayong end term which is 7. If we're going to apply them guys, itong gagamitin natin, a sub 1 times the quantity 1 minus r raised to n all over 1 minus r. Ibig sabihin, after we try to solve them, since we're looking for the 7th day, meron po tayo dito guys, 508 na person na na-recorded na cases nung virus na yun within that 7 days. Ibig sabihin guys, yun po yung total sum ng those item. Now, I'm not going to explain further guys kung paano siya in-sinolve kasi po, meron tayong mga video about solving this item. Ipinapakita ko lang sa inyo guys that this item or this type of problem solving can be applied on real life situation. Okay? So, kung napansin niyo po, that's how we try to use geometric and arithmetic on problem solving. At sana po guys, natutunan ninyo po kung paano to i-solve. So, sige, bigyan natin ng pasada ng konti. So, dito, sinubstitute lamang siya. 1 half raised to 7 is 1 over 28. Itong 1 guys, kaya naging 127 shot. 128 over 128 minus 1, kaya naging 127. After nun, ito guys, at saka ito kinancel. Ito naging times 2. 2 times 1, 27, kaya po naging 254. Itong 1 half, binareciprocal siya, kaya po siya naging 508. Okay? So seemingly on those item, guys, madali mong makita immediately kung ano yung hinahanap mo pagkakataon ng those number. Okay? So let us try to recall arithmetic and geometric. So sequence of number, both of them, tapos guys, constant sila. Pag arithmetic ay difference, common difference, and we're going to add. At kapag geometric naman, common ratio, and we're going to multiply. Now, para malaman natin whether you understand our discussion, I'm going to leave you these two problems. Identify natin kung arithmetic siya and geometric, and after that, guys, try to solve those items within 5 minutes para malaman natin whether you understand our discussion or not. So, 5 minutes start now. Now guys, let's try to check your work. The number of infected person in the community during the first day of the GCQ is 4,816. So ang after yun guys, ano daw yung magiging possible number of infected on the 7th day? Now after we're trying to solve this item guys, we will identify 4,816 as our given item. So 8 divided by 4 equals to 2, 16 divided by 2 is 8 is equals to 2. Therefore guys, we're looking for the common ratio. So after natin isolve guys, ito ma-identify natin ang first term natin ay 4, ang n natin ay 7 since we're looking for the 7th day. Tapos ang r natin ay 2. So a7 equals to 4 quantity 2 times 7 minus 1. Ito po yung equation na ginamit natin. So a7 o a sub 7 equals to 4 times the quantity 2 raised to 6. So guys, ang 2 raised to 6 po ay 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 or 64. And after nun guys, we're having a sub 7 is equal to 256. Ibig sabihin po, ang infected person on the 7th day is 256. Now, we will continue with our another problem. So, JV is getting better at mathematics class. They have 50 item tests every week. Ibig sabihin, so first week natin guys, 21, 24, 27, on the first, second, at saka third. Kung mag-increase guys ang rate niya, ano yung possible score niya after the 40th test? Ibig sabihin, 21, 24, 27 is an arithmetic sequence. So, 24 minus 21 is 3, 27 minus 24 is 3. Therefore, upon solving guys, so a sub 1 equals to 21, n equals to 8, d is equals to 3. At pag solve natin guys, on the 8th day, that will become 42. Ibig sabihin po, ang score niya on the 8th day is 42. Okay? And ganun guys natin gamitin yung ating mga problem on sequence. And I hope guys, natutunan niyo po kung paano siya isolve. Kung po may tanong po kayo, don't forget to comment down below doon sa ating video para mas mabigyan po natin pansin. Okay? So and I hope you learned something from this video guys. If you like this video, kindly like this. Share it with your friends. At huwag mong kalimutan mag-subscribe sa ating channel. Lunga po pala guys. Next natin topic is polynomial. So see you again guys sa ating next video. Maraming salamat po at God bless.